I yeah yeah seems fair, seems fair. Right, so I'm going to be updating the scoreboard because that's also important, else people don't know who's playing. We're going to be playing on the Haunted Mines, El Nexo's favorite spot to be playing on, and I also have to say I like the Haunted Mines a lot, especially after they changed a little bit of all the mechanics here. Right, so Tesher, do you want to introduce the blue team?
I will, in fact, introduce the blue team starting in the top lane. The team is El Nexo, and we have Graham PKT on the Brightwing. Lucifron will be playing Prince Arthas. LoL versus XD will be on the Valor. Alistar is playing the Sarge, is playing the Falstead, sorry, and Vortex is Commander Rayna.
And on the other side, we have the team of Well Matt, with Hirokay playing Well Matt, Nomi playing Stitches, Hasuaus playing Tykus, Hysterica playing Kerrigan, and finally we have Sokke playing the Tyrande. And both teams immediately going towards their observatory. And I'm kind of curious what El Nexo is doing here. They're just waiting a little
Yeah,
bit.
I think they're trying to stay as far back in their vision as possible to try and look. They're definitely trying to avoid the Stitches hook. But I guess they were trying to draw the rest of they were trying to draw the west of Wellmet in. So I'm not sure.
I'm also a little bit curious about the choice here once again by Well Matt. I know that they actually picked up their heroes just because of this 4 versus 4 fight that we're seeing more and more. But yeah, Nomi, Hirokay, and Hysterica just hiding behind the gate, just making them think, oh,
Hiding
they're.
themselves from vision. It's very
I
nice.
like this. Oh, Nomi, why are you going in?
Yeah, Nobi tried to go for a hook, but we can see our next. So we're playing a bit safer. So it is pretty nice. And they're looking for their Neva team looking for an engagement here. They're just trying to deal with this. And Well Met are playing four people in their
Oh, there's Duke.
non-Golem lane, but they're going on to Lucifer. The stun from Tyrande, and Lucifer goes down! And that's a good reason to pick up Tyrande. The triple stun coming in from the hook, the Ufa, and the Tyrande. Very nice chain. That's very cool. And that is one of the reasons they are running with this four people in the bot lane. It may not be their Golem lane, but Tykus is more than capable of keeping up with Alistar in the top lane. So their Neva team is going to get their lane pushed up. They can counter
Vortex,
the
LoL versus
Inspire well
60.
enough. Oh, has
No,
got to be out
actually,
there.
I like what El Nexo is doing. They're like, okay, we're doing this once, and now we're going somewhere else completely. We're going directly into the top lane. We're going to make sure that Hasuaps has no chance in that top lane. Going to try and deal as much damage as we can to the
They're going to
towers.
get a tower
Towers.
out of this.
Yeah, this is a very good. And this is going to give them a little bit of experience, exactly the experience they actually lost when dealing with. Oh, nice teleport by Grand PKT there, immediately going into the mines. And oh my god, oh my word,
Five
it's
versus
so bright
five.
here. Lucifron, he's just in the lead there, takes the hit
Why
from
is
the
it so
owl here.
bright?
Nomi looking for the hook. Oh, he catches it over 60. So much damage being put down here. And both heroes going down, just getting bursted. Now Vortex trying to escape here. He's getting his passive procced. And oh my word, there was just a little bit too much damage. You can see Falstead actually going to the other side. Grand PKT in even all more sorts of trouble. The hook, not from Hysterica. He doesn't really have the teleport, correction, the mana for it. But it is Well Met, who has 36 out of the 100 skulls already.
Yeah, but they are still grabbing them. But now, Sokke has run into a bit of trouble here, meeting Brightwing and Alistar. He will definitely go down. And here comes the rest of El Nexo, gonna try and salvage what is left of this mine. There's one camp down here that they kind of need. But for now, they're just gonna chase Well Met out of here. And Well Met completely backing up. But Hasuaps gets locked down. It's now Hysteria. He's been envenomed and he is trapped. He will go down. And El Nexo taking control. They have to get this bottom camp if they want the advantage, and LoL versus XD has arrived in the mines. He will clear that up. Now the rest of El Nexo going straight for that golem.
This is a smart move by Well Met, by the way. They're moving towards all of the mercenary camps, going to take those away from El Nexo, and especially these here, the siege giants that Hirokay is currently fighting with together with Nomi and Sokke. If they take those away, it's going to be a lot harder to fight back against the golem, because El Nexo tends to go for the siege camp, or rather, each team tends to go for the siege camp just in order to stop it, to stop the grave golem. And now it's even going to be fighting together with them. So this is not looking too good for the for those guys. Actually, Lucifron now going to lock up Nomi here. Nomi in a lot of trouble. He's going to get jumped upon, but he pulls in Lucifron together with Hysterica.
Oh, he's
Lucifron's
so low.
So low, but the healing from Brightwing is just enough. And that's going to allow El Nexo to survive this one. Grenade being popped out to force back Alistar and LoL vs XD. And now the Grave Golems are pretty much of equal strength.
Yep, super solid counter engage here by Wellmet, able to completely counter the El Nexo. I guess that was technically a gank, even though it was in their own jungle. But we're now going to see Wellmet taking their Siege Giants, and this is much better for them, due to the fact that their Siege Giants will help kill the El Nexo Golem. El Nexo, though, are helping their Golem push, but they're going to run into the majority of Wellmet here. Brightwing joining El Nexo as well, and it's 4-3. Stitches will be joining Wellmet soon, though. But Wellmet do have the Golems, and the Giants, and they're going to help, but now they're actually in range to be killed because of how Wellmet, El Nexo, have been helping here. But they're probably going to kill this Golem off before it does take down the fort. Whereas Wellmet's Golem still completely clean here, it's going to be able to take down the towers.
Also, Mule now coming in. Smart move there by, I believe, Uther that picks up the Mule here.
No, Uther can't take Mule. It is Tyrande.
Okay, it's Tyrande. Smart move here. Picking up the Mule. It already got taken down, though. But in the top lane, the top golem, the red golem for the team of Wellmet, didn't do all that much. It might have been a little bit weaker, but because of the fact that El Nexo rotated all the way to the bot lane together with their full team, well, even with those Siege Giants, they dealt a much more severe blow to the team of Wellmet.
Yeah, this is the case, and Wellmet looking to maybe roll in and try and steal this Bruiser Cap, but the root coming down from Arthur's stopped Hiruke going in, and that was their engage opportunity. So El Nexo grabbing the Bruiser Cap, Wellmet pulling back to engage to clear this up before they do lose too much ammo. And they only have one tower left up here, but El Nexo going to respond to this and immediately dive onto this bottom four, and they're going to be able to kill it, Mule or not. That will go down, and this is what El Nexo do. They create distractions and they create opportunities, and down goes the fort. And El Nexo really liking their dives here. Wellmet looking for their opportunity, but now they are in some trouble. And they're finally going to be able to clear up the Bruiser Camp in the top lane, and the Mule has been sent there as well, as there's basically nothing left bot lane to defend.
Yeah, so just work on the gate, work on the tower, maybe. Does it also work on walls? I don't know exactly.
It does not, unless the wall is literally the only thing around.
Okay.
Oh, well, the stun combo coming down.
Lucifer just getting popped here, that's the end of him. Now, Artis has already fallen. Hysterica getting a nice heal there from Hiruke, and they're trying to turn it around. The mines are not open yet, so it's going to take another 30 seconds. There's the hook.
Yeah, oh, the stun combos every time!
Chocolat coming out as well. Hysterica and Loft over the Rain of Vengeance is going to lock down Kerrigan. And now El Nexo, having the experience advantage, is going to just one by one take down anyone who decides to stick around. And wow, that level up for El Nexo. So good.
Yeah, really well timed. And Wellmet was so close to leveling up as well. And that was super close. I'm loving the stun combos coming out from Wellmet, but that fight for El Nexo was just so much better. They were able to turn, and the Rain of Vengeance just destroyed them. But here is the fight. The trap was there. It is the Starfall coming out from Tyrande, but she gets taken down. There's the hook. Lucifrod does get Gorge Hysteria a bit early there, and there goes Lucifrod. He's going to try and make a break for it, but he might not go down, actually. He has Army of the Dead. He roots Kerrigan and Nomi, and they're chasing him, and the Army of the Dead, he is healing himself very heavily here. Hasuobs has come down to help as well. There's the Overdrive about to come out. The stun goes down, and Lucifron finally does die. But while this is happening, El Nexo have already won the mines.
I'm a little bit confused as to why Vortix actually ran himself straight into the enemy team. He could have retreated into the mines, helped his team a little bit more. But what El Nexo now can do is just shove the bottom lane, get themselves even more of a foothold in that bottom lane, as well as being able to pick up the observatory and the Siege Giant camp here. They have Falstad, they have Brightwing. Falstad dashed over the wall. He can double bribe. Yeah, there it is. Siege Giants are going to go into the top lane, and there's nothing that's going to be defending against that golem in the bottom lane. Except the tower, but I wouldn't call that defense.
Yeah, but it's going to be a 60 skull golem as well, which is devastating. This is going to be quite difficult for them. And someone was asking about why the mule was put on the gate. The way the mule works in this game is its priority is really wonky. So if you place the mule, in order to get the mule to repair what you want, you have to place it on the building that's nearest to it, but isn't it. So if you want the building, the mule to repair the tower, you put it on the gate. If you want it to repair the gate, you put it on the tower. If you want it to repair the fort, you put it on the fountain. It's very weird.
It's, yeah, that's the issue. Although, five-man push in the bottom lane, five-man retaliation here by the team of Well-Met. And the Golem is already making short work of this tower. It's going to be moving in together with Well-Met. And we already saw what happened last time. The team that went with the Golem was able to take, or rather dish out even more damage. There's the hook onto Alistar. Oh, he gets gorged! Alistar in a lot of trouble. He gets gorged behind.
Does he have his dash?
The walls. That's, yeah, he has the dash.
Oh my god!
Starfall, Starfall, not enough. And that's going to be just enough for LNexo to say, okay, we're out. Have a nice day.
That was so close. Just clipped the edge of the gate, and that was enough for the path for the object being solid to push him over, and he just escaped by the skin of his teeth there. And we do see Well-Met clearing up the Golem, but now they're going to lose their... They're not going to lose their top forward, actually. LNexo deciding not to dive this one, and Well-Met are going to be here in time to defend. LNexo getting ready, though. They have Siege Giants with them now, and they're going to go and start sieging this.
This one actually moving in just a little bit for the root, gets the root down at the Sake, and with the Siege Giants, like you said, they're going to be... He hooked the Banshee. Okay, that's an interesting one. I didn't know you could actually hook the Banshee, but apparently that's the case.
Banshees are completely solid. They are affectable by all CC and damage.
Well, we just found out. Just hook the Banshee. For now, though, Bruiser Camp also going into the hands of LNexo. And now that we have a little bit of a lull in the battle, we're going to be able to look at those talents that have been picked up. So Divine Storm, Maelstrom, Commoner Odin, Gorge, and Starfall being picked up for Stitches, Tychus, Kerrigan, and Uther, and Tyrande, of course. And on the other side, not Giant Killer, Reyes Raiders, we saw them, Shock and Awe, Army of the Dead, Reign of Vengeance, and Blink Heal for Brightwing. Those are the heroic abilities. But is there anything very special? Well, Vala is going for that build. Oh, Grand PKT gets hooked.
Oh my god.
Oh my word.
Now, this is where Well-Met's comp will I've completely forgotten the world.
Excel,
that's the word. Thank you very much. And this is where Well-Met's comp will excel, just picking off members of LNexo. But LNexo, they're winning everywhere else. And just picking people off is not going to be enough unless you can get to the late game where the respawn timers are long. And guess what's not going to happen on the Haunted Mines? A late game.
And Alistar, Lucifron, Lovers, XDK, and Vortex are moving into the mines. I'm actually zooming in just to get a good glimpse of everybody. Brightwing moving in. Starting to become more and more of a light show. And, well, Matt, they're a little bit late to the party here. They should have gone into the mines already. But yeah, they have to be very careful because, well...
The fact that Unicorn is so neon does not help in the slightest from Vortex.
Not at all.
Yeah, but here we go. Well-Met moving in. We're going to see a fight. It's 5v5. Nomi hooks onto Alistar. He's going to try and run backwards. The root has gone down into Sake, Hestercia, and Alistar is just going to dash his way out, but he's dashed into the Starfall. Hiruke is coming in. He gets polymorphed. Hestercia does go down to Lucifron, though. There's the Shock and Awe. Doesn't really do anything. Hiruke does go down, though. It's Nomi, Sake, and Hasuobs left, as opposed to the entire team of LNexo. They are able to micro their way out of this and stay alive. And I'm pretty sure I just saw an owl come
Brightwing
through.
Brightwing in trouble, gets locked up in the Divine Storm, and now Hasuobs is going to try and chase it down with the Overdrive. Is already out of his Odin form. There's the hook onto a skeleton. That's not what he wants to hook. And well, Matt knows, we're in a load of trouble. We're going to be moving towards the other skeleton camps, going to try and take those out pretty fast. They're doing a good job there, though, but it's not going to be even close to enough, as LNexo already has 46 out of these skulls. And now they're moving in onto Nomi. And they're going to be forcing him away, and that's going to allow LNexo to maybe, if they're fast, get a 76 skull golem.
Yep, it is possible. So, we're going to see LNexo, they're clearing this as quick as possible, and Well-Met going to try and react to this in, I think, probably the best way. Looks like they're going to push with their wave here, and maybe try and steal this, take this bot fort, but no, they're actually just going to raid into LNexo's jungle and try and steal the watchtower. Not going to go for the easy cap. Now they're heading to the bot lane. They hook onto Lucifron, and Lucifron goes down super quick. He was far too low to be that far forward. And now Well-Met are going to push in. Nice blink heal from Grand PKT to dodge that Starfall from Sokei. Not Starfall, sorry. I don't actually know what the name of that ability is. Lunar Flare, that's the one.
Lunar Flare, yeah. Starfall is the ultimate.
Yeah. It's the Starfall, that's Moonfire, and I wasn't actually aware of what that's called. So Lunar Flare, good.
But still, 76 skull golem. That's a golem that's at least three times as strong. Well, I'm not entirely sure what the exact figures are, but it's at least a lot stronger than the opposing golem. Takes already down one of these towers, and well, Matt doing a good job at least stopping the golem. I mean, they're not taking it down fast, but it's going fast enough. It's down to half hit points, and they should be able to take it down.
They'll save their keep from this, as opposed to, I think the keep might have died if the golem was left unattended. But we can see that Eldexo did take down Wellmet's golem quite a while ago. That went down almost instantly. Sokke, once again, standing in the root. That does do a lot of damage, Sokke. You need to be very careful with that. But Ufa is healing that up. And down goes the golem, only taking about a quarter of that bottom keep away. And there is the mule to
still
begin
better than what
that.
The golem did for the team of... for Wellmet. I mean, it only took down the tower to about 10% health, but it didn't get to the keep at all. So even if the golem already took down the gate and the towers, and that's already a big win for Eldexo.
They decided to take it. The hook almost getting Vortex. That was close.
Yeah, it's very interesting how these teams are playing. Now with the Bruiser Camp and Siege Camp in the top lane, going towards the base of Wellmet. Sokke is looking to jump into here with his Lunar Flare. Yeah, there we go.
Yep, so we are seeing Wellmet just having to play on the defensive because that's all they can do. Nomi looking for the picks. This is basically what Wellmet have been reduced to. Their base, stay near their towers, try and protect their buildings, and look for the hook opportunities. Nomi will likely be looking for a hook over here onto the Siege Giants, but there was no one there due to the fact that all of Eldexo are playing it safe, playing far away from Wellmet's base, and like we said, Wellmet just playing very defensively.
Interesting, talent's already being picked up here for Kerrigan, choosing to increase her Impaling Blades radius. Uther going for the Imposing Presence rather than the skill that reduces the cooldowns if you're above 80%
hardened
health.
Hardened Focus,
yeah. It's always hard to keep those in mind, and even Brightwing not going for that one, going more for the Critterize to just take down whoever gets near. And now, well, Eldexo moving into the mines here, and you can see, well, Matt is like, do we want to go in, guys?
They have to, but the thing is, they revealed themselves by killing these minions. They're actually kind of waiting here, but they keep revealing themselves by sticking out the brush with these minions around, and we can see Eldexo are ready to try and fight here. Well met. I think they headed up there to try and bait them out. They're going to head in here. And now, well met. Eldexo were not ready here. They still get a root down. There's the hook onto Alistar. Alistar dashing out quickly. Rain of Vengeance hits Niruke twice. Niruke gets annihilated instantly. And also down goes Stitches. And Kerrigan has Swarms already on the retreat. Sokke is in the worst position here. He's having to run into the mines. And we're going to see Eldexo are chasing him down. Vortex is mounted up. He's going to chase him. And Falstad flies ahead of him. And Sokke is in trouble. He will go down. There's the dash out of the Lunar Flare. And Sokke will die here. There we go.
Yeah, there we go. It took a little bit longer, but look at the amount of skills that Eldexo already has. Even if they decide to go straight back to their base to get all the mercenary camps, it is already way too much to handle. 68 skills, and now they're going straight for the final golem. It's not a 100 skill golem hype, but it is a 98 skill golem. And, well, if I have to say, and I have to say so myself, 98 is pretty much 100.
Yep, pretty much. 98 is as close as you're going to get to 100. That two skull golem from Wellmet isn't really going to do much.
Look at what Brightwing is doing right now. He's doing exactly the same thing as before.
I like it. Wait until the last moment. Brightwing can teleport out whenever she wants. The team of Eldexo have bead back. They're ready. They are prepared. They're in the positions they need to be. They're clearing their waves. They're getting their defenses ready to so their waves will be in time to fight that golem, and they are getting ready to meet up in the spot lane to push.
So apparently, one of us is louder. So I'm going to... what we're going to be doing before we fight... head into the next game, we will do a quick sound test.
You can tell us which one is louder
so we can adjust later. So yeah, it's Technolink and...
Tetra.
Okay.
Alright, so Nomi did attempt to hook in there, but he was not able to land it onto anyone. Lucifron also not able to get his root down, but this golem is 100% going to get this keep. The question is, how much health will it have Once it is done, will it be able to push onto the core? Golem destroying everything right now, and the hook does land onto Lucifrod. There is the gorge, and too eager there by Soke. Hysteria does have a stun, and he does land it though. Lucifrod though, able to back out. He is retreating. He's healing himself as much as possible with his ultimate, and he is going to survive. Down goes Ufa though, and Lucifrod once again backing out. There goes the shock and awe. But this is pretty much over unless we can see Wellmet get some kills. Grand PKT does go down. Can they keep killing off members? I don't think it's going to be enough even if they do, because the Golem is killing their core. Hysteria being dropped low. Alistair being forced to retreat. Vortex will go down, but Lucifrod is still alive in the back, wailing on this core, as well as Lombus 60. Lombus 60 does go down, but it doesn't matter. Golem wins the game, and El Nexo takes game number one.
Haven't watched it.
Okay, well, there is a line in that where there are basically demands being made, and one of the demands is get the police girl a gun, but I already have a gun. Get that bitch a cannon.
Okay. I'm more of the Dragon Ball Z abridged, if you don't mind.
Same people.
I know.
So watch both. They are both very entertaining. Like, you will watch the first few episodes and you will love it. There's only 5 episodes currently because they make one a year, which sucks. But would you like to introduce the players?
Yes, it's Hiroke in the blue trunks playing on Uther. We're looking at Hysterica playing on Falstad, Noe playing on Artis, and in the bottom side of the map, it's Hasuops playing on the Sergeant Hammer, and finally Soke flittering around to the middle lane playing on Anubarak.
And they are well met. So, spawning on the right-hand side in the red trunks, starting in the mid lane, we have Alistair on the Valor, we have Grand PKT on the Brightwing. We have LOL versus XD on the Illidan. Vortex is on the Tychus, and Lucifron is on the Chen. And they are El Nexo, and they are setting a trap.
Oh my word! Hello, Hasuops. What are you doing?
Hasuops. Oh my god! And he's gone.
It's not really Hasuops. It's Hasu. Oops.
Yes, whoops, yeah, very much so. And we can see, well, they're instantly reacting to this by sending quite a few people to this bot lane in case this turns out that this free man push is a thing, and it's definitely going to be. We can see El Nexo trying to make the most of the situation while they have free people down here and gain control of this. This does mean there's going to be quite a violent fight over the bottom lane chest.
Yeah. It's a hard thing to get off your chest, and LOL vs XD together with Vortex should be able to easily get the full amount of coins. Top lane though, there's a little bit of a fight, but Alistar and Grand PKT are able to get themselves most of these coins. Noemi now coming in, they're looking to lock up Alistar. Vortex actually has rotated up to the top lane, going to try and deal as much damage to Hiroke as they can. There's the nade, didn't quite toss Hiroke into the fight, and now the Pirate Bay has arrived.
Yep, the ship has arrived, and that didn't actually cause as much latency as it usually does.
I had a little bit of a spike, yeah.
I had a tiny bit, but better than usual. So we're now seeing El Nexo, as usual, dominating the game. They got 7 out of the 10 coins. 3 were stolen by Hiroke and Noemi on the side of Wellmet. Alistair now going on to Hysterica. I'm not sure what Alistair thought he could do there, but was not able to get anything done. But he's going to be able to clear this wave pretty nicely. Top lane, however, pretty much completely in control of El Nexo. Hiroke is being forced way out of XP range, and now LOL vs XD going to be able to clear all of this and grab all the XP. In the meantime, bot lane finally going the way Wellmet wants. Hasuops is getting free reign to wipe out these towers. Grand PKT being able to do pretty much nothing. A little bit of harass coming down, but the tower will still fall.
Yeah, this is the issue with dealing with a Sergeant Hammer in that bottom lane. You have to send in more than one person, and if you do, you leave open the rest of your sides. Now, Soke is in a lot of trouble, but he's able to deep tunnel out of there together with the Lurker smash, as I like to call it.
Oh my god, Vortex going on to Hasuops! No overdrive though, but they still get him! Vortex though has been envenomed, he gets knocked up, Brightwing's heal did not come in time, he does go down. So that was a 1-for-1 Tychus for Sergeant Hammer, and the XP lead is a tiny bit in favour of El Nexo, and Lucifron's going to try and get them a little bit more, but they're not too bad. I just like the way. The reason they are ahead in XP, though, kills are almost even. They are one slight kill ahead, and they were able to completely deny the XP in that top lane, and it was very well done. So, well, Nexo, just taking any advantage they can.
Yeah, and their opponents, they're getting ready to at least get themselves their own advantages. The camps have spawned, so the Doubloon camp going over to Noemi, easy pickups there. They're going to be picking up the Siege Giant camp pretty soon as well, I imagine. But the same happens for the other team. The guys from El Nexo are moving in onto their own camps, although their opponents have a little bit of a head start here. The advantage that El Nexo has, though, is the fact that they're going to be hitting their level 7 talents pretty soon, and that's going to give Chen his much-needed pressure point, which is going to allow him to root people he kicks.
Yep, this is the case, and we can also see that El Nexo were able to take their own Bruiser camp, so that's going to seriously help them with pushing. Grand PKT doing a good job with this as well. Sergeant Hammer still hanging around in this bottom lane, but now it is Chen here who's going to be able to jump onto Hasselwobbs if Hasselwobbs ventures too far. So Hasselwobbs going to be staying out of siege mode for the moment, going to be playing safe. There are siege giants with him. Let them get engaged upon first. And we're now seeing Vortex and LoL vs XD. They are heading to turn.
Grand PKT at the same time on the other side of the map is going to get taken out. But I'm getting the feeling that was just a bait to get him away from the handing point.
This seems quite likely because that is a full turn in for El Nexo. And now they are moving on to Hasselwobbs. Hasselwobbs being forced to back up. And El Nexo going to be able to grab this bottom chest as well. Top chest was taken by Wellmet though.
Yeah, but that's not going to give them their full hand in just yet. Actually, it does. Nomi has 9. But it's going to be hard for Nomi to actually get himself into a position where he's going to be able to hand in due to the fact that right now the guys from El Nexo have a 3-man push in the bottom lane together with the Night Camp. It's going to put serious pressure onto Hasselwobbs.
Yep, Hasselwobbs is probably the best suited person to defend against this, though. And that's what he's going to be doing. He does bonus damage to minions. I can actually tell you how much, but stuff is about to happen. They're going on to Nomi. Lucifron is the one out of position, though. He's taking the most damage, but Nomi is still going to go down. Drops all of his 9 coins. Hysterica also going to go down. Drops his 5, I think, coins was that. And El Nexo just stealing everything. Take from them everything and leave them nothing. And that is horrible for Wellmet.
Yeah, and the only thing they have left is a jar of dirt, and that's not going to help them at this point. Another barrage of these cannons is going to be taking down the fort. 2 shots, that's all it takes. And LoL vs XD already forcing Sokke away. Cannon's now going to be looking at the top lane, which have already been damaged. So that's going to be a full destruction of this side. And the only thing that didn't go down is that top turret. But to add onto the pressure in the top lane, look at the Grave Golem. It is going to go the way of El Nexo, and they're just putting their foot down. Guys, you had your chance, but yeah, now it's our turn.
They're grabbing full control. Hasselwobbs is trying to do something down here. He has gone for the bonus damage build rather than the lifesteal build, so has very little sustain here. Even with the 30% extra damage to minions and structures in his siege mode, that doesn't help against Brightwing. And Brightwing has a lot more sustain than Sergeant Hammer when Sergeant Hammer has not taken any kind of lifesteal.
And that's, doesn't really matter. Hirokay actually got into position to assist Hasselwobbs here, and I like what they're doing right now. They have the coins for pretty much a full turn in if they get one of the bloom camps, but they're just going to go straight towards the fort. Take that one down, make your own hand-ins a lot stronger. But there's one thing they also have to keep in mind here, and that's the fact that, well, look at the top lane. There's a Grave Golem moving in, and that's going to try and take down the keep together with the rest of the team of El Nexo.
Yep, El Nexo pushing this in. Brightwing is the one in the bot lane clearing up this wave so that their fort in the bot lane does survive. It will actually go down to this minion wave, I'm pretty sure, but Brightwing can teleport to help her team whenever. But the push is over, so Brightwing's instead going to head into this bottom easy. She did have double bribe and is going to steal that instead. And the minion wave actually got there just in time to save the El Nexo bottom lane fort. And Brightwing teleporting to the turn-in and safety, and that will give her team another turn-in. Yes, with Illidan.
Yes, exactly. I was under the impression that they would get the exact, or rather at least put their coins in the bank, because they don't want them to be, they don't want to get mugged as they're trying to traverse the map. But now the bottom fort is going to go down just to
it's
one.
It's so low,
wave.
It just won't die.
I'm talking about the blue fort.
Okay, well, the red fort just won't die. It's been hit so many times, it just will not fall. And bot blue fort actually won't die. It will get down to, I think, a third health, maybe a quarter. But it will actually survive due to how many buildings were still alive in this bottom lane when the cannon barrage did start.
Point taken. Yeah, that's the issue with not pushing hard enough. Right, so for now, how many coins does the team of Wellmet have? They have 4-3-1. That's 8 coins. That's not enough for a hand in, and they're not going to be able to actually get themselves the hand in anytime soon because all the camps are down. There is a there are treasure chests now spawning, but Alistar and Vortex are already on the top one, and Grand PKT is just hanging about, just chilling at the bottom chest, waiting for his team to arrive.
Yep, we can see Wellmet, though, are here as well. They're waiting to engage, and Elnexo, they do get onto the chest first. Wellmet not wanting to fight. There comes the poke from Nubrak. Does not land on anyone. It's quite easy to dodge if you can see it coming, which they did. And now Elnexo just going to turn all of these in, and that should and be another 10 coins. That's another full coins. In.
That's 16 coins.
Is it? Oh my god.
It's exactly 16 coins. Every single time, it is exactly what they need to hand in.
Elnexo.
Very well done by them.
Masters of counting. Masters of the exact amount of turn-ins.
Yeah, they're probably some master's degree in computation or
quite like calculus. I know they're both were. Lizifron and Vortex were students in something while they were StarCraft pros, but I don't know what. And now they're going on to Sokke. Sokke being dropped low instantly, and while you're polymorphed, no way to pop your shield, and it wouldn't have helped anyway. And Sokke does go down. Elnexo just dominating this map. If this was the mines, it would, and they have played this well in the mines and got this much advantage on the mines, this game would be over already.
Yeah, definitely. Elnexo now just going to put down a bit of pressure here onto this keep. They're going to get slowed down, though, by the auto-attacks because there are no minions to go with it. And Lulfus XD has to be a little bit careful here, although they're jumping onto Hazorps. Hazorps immediately boosting straight out of there. Now they're onto Lucifron. Lucifron can't escape. He doesn't have anything except his ultimate, but he gets rooted. All three of his ultimate forms got rooted. Was able to jump out just by sheer, well, I guess just jamming the button. Get out, get out, get out. But this might be the moment where Wellmet can get one hand in. They have to go right now if they have the coins, but they don't.
They're going to try, and it's just no matter what Wellmet do, they can't catch a break. They got to kill someone. They've got 2 kills overall, and that was in the early game. And right now, Elnexo just dominating the control of the map, stealing the Bruiser camp from directly under Wellmet's noses, and there is nothing they can do about it. And Elnexo just keeping on the pressure in every lane. Wellmet, though, they are going to be able to take their own bottom Bruiser camp, Siege camp, which will give them a little bit of ease in that bottom lane, but there's 2 sets of knights in this top lane for them to deal with.
Another thing to keep in mind here is that the Grave Golem is going to be respawning in about 10 seconds, so that's going to be even more pressure on the map for the team of Elnexo. And yeah, the guys, when I'm looking at Wellmet, it looks it's probably not going to happen anymore.
Yeah,
that's the issue.
They can do it.
They need a full hand in. They need it now. They should anticipate their opponents to be taking the Grave Golem, so they should be on the hand in point, and then they shouldn't be getting out of their horses. So Nomi's going to get the hand in. Haswaps here, okay. Okay, they get one hand in. Is it going to be enough? It's not even going to take down one fort.
Nope. It is still completely fine. Like you said, won't take down a single fort, and well met. That is basically the seal for them. They are going to steal the bottom easy cap, though, from Elnexo, and they are all being back to base, the ones that aren't there already. Midkeep is about to go down. There is nothing they can do about that, but they are now all here, and this is where they have to fight. But the slow came out from Valor, and Elnexo already are out.
Yeah, they're Wellmet immediately rotating up to the top lane, going to deal with this Grave Golem here. It's going down pretty fast, so Wellmet only going to be losing one tower, most likely, and that's going to allow them to clear out this wave as well. They do get some damage down onto these towers in the bottom lane, but Lucifron is here. He's going to be trying to deal with these Grave Golems.
He won't clear them very quickly at all. He's going to be able to fire them and kick them, etc. But he's actually going to struggle to clear them. We might actually see them take the 2 that aren't aggroed onto him take down a tower. But no, here's the rest of his team, and they will be able to clear these up. On his own, though, might have been a struggle.
Yeah, if we're actually looking at it, now that we have a little bit of time, we can look at the talents, or don't
no,
we don't have time.
This is risky, this is a bad move, but they might actually be able to get Lucifron. Lucifron does ult, he's going to back out of there as quick as possible, and now we can see the rest of Elnexo reacting to this on their way down to the bot lane. Well met, their job here is done, they've instilled fear in Lucifron's heart and forced Lucifron to ult, so they are going to use the opportunity to back up.
I like what Wellmet is doing here. They're moving towards that middle fort, going to take that one down, get themselves some experience here. They've hit level 16, so if they want to fight, they have to do it within the next few moments. If we're looking at talent, I haven't been looking at talents just yet, but the treasure chests are now up. Alnexo, just hanging back a little bit, they have 17 coins in their possession. If they lose Illidan, that would be horrid, and it would at least give Wellmet two handeds in a row.
Yep, and we can see that Alnexo is still playing very cautiously. They're looking for their opportunity to fight, and they just don't want to get caught here. And we can see Wellmet will likely reveal themselves very soon here by taking this top chest. We will, Alnexo will see the number going down, so they will know it is time to react. And they're going to take the bottom bruiser cap.
And now that we have a little bit of time before they take it, a stone skin on Artis, Overdrive on Havalstat, another stone skin on Size Hammer, Uther with the imposing presence, and Blood for Blood on Anubarak. On the other side, stone skin for Tychus, combination attack for Chen, Vala going for the Executioner, Blood for Blood for Illidan, and finally Critterize for Brightwing as level 16 talents.
Yeah, this is the case, but Alnexo are just completely let Wellmet get the turn in and are going to use this opportunity to take control of this bottom lane and see if they can maybe get another keep, but they've already forced Wellmet to back.
Yeah, Wellmet is in a really bad position here because there are two Sea Giants and four Knights moving in onto these towers. Towers are falling very, very fast, and Wellmet needs to fight right now if they want to at least save their towers. Looks like they're not willing to do so just yet, so they're just cleaning up here and then just allowing their opponents to go towards the turning point. Speaking of which, 13 plus 6 is 19. Gnomi is in a lot of trouble. He gets popped. Goodbye.
They go down so quick. It's so much damage from Alnexo here. And Wellmet, even though they're only technically one level behind, they just pop instantly anytime they try to fight, and they just can't do it. There we go. There's the full turn in from Alnexo again, keeping control of this game drastically. And they're just going to once again steal Wellmet's Bruiser Camp. And
get this keep.
So bad for Wellmet.
Yeah, this keep is down.
Yep, that is gone. And it's actually going to take down a lot of the bottom lane as well. It'll take down at least both towers and actually the gate and both towers only on one shot. I do not know if that will take down the four. No, it won't. It will not.
That was interesting. It shot a bullet it didn't need to shoot. That's a new one. Haven't seen that one before.
Yeah, it does do that, which is why you shouldn't actually damage buildings that are already targeted by the cannon.
Yeah, but it wasn't targeted even. It wasn't even targeted.
I know, that's just general advice.
Yeah, true enough. But at the same time, a little bit. Usually it tends to at least say, okay, you have about 500 hit points left, so I'm only firing with one shot instead of two. But Alnexo just going to continue clearing out the map. They have four coins on Lull versus XD. They have two coins on Alistar, five coins on Lucifron. I can just hit the tab button. That's a lot easier. They don't have enough for a full hand in, though. And their opponents, they're moving around the observatory area, which is a little bit scary, though. Because, well, that's going to just proc Alnexo in taking down the keep in one go.
Yep, they are just all going to die of it. Showing yourselves at that watchtower does mean that Alnexo know exactly where you are. And Wellmet, nowhere near in time to defend this keep. And Alnexo going to back up here. They're going to kite and wait for their opportunity to re-engage. There's a shock. Oh, hits absolutely no one. Knockup, though, gets Vortex and Alistair. Lucifer has had to pop his ult. And there is the fight. The turnaround comes out of Wellnexo. There is the Divine Storm, though, by Hiruke. But it's not going to be enough. Lomas XD chasing onto Hysteria. Lucifron going on him as well. Hasselhobbs is being forced to micro backwards, but he's getting body boxed. There comes the kill. Hysteria still alive. Hiruke is going to go down as well as Nomi, thanks to the big red button. And Hysterica does survive, but that is a 4-0. In favor of Alnexo. They're going to dive this for with the help of some Siege Giants, and that will be GG. And Alnexo are your second finalists, and they will move on to play My Insanity.
And those matches will be played right after this game, so make sure to stay tuned as the core health has dropped to zero. Thatcher, what a game. I mean, Alnexo, they took control of the early game and then suddenly just shifted into overdrive.
Yep, Alnexo played spectacularly well, showing the dominance that they have shown throughout this tournament. And like you said, they gave away a couple kills in the early game, but this is actually why the roaming squad seems to have fallen out of fashion a bit, because although you get a couple extra kills, the game is never, ever won in the early game. It is won in the mid to late game, and this is where Alnexo have been showing dominance.
Right, and with that wisdom, we're going to head into a quick break. a little bit of music, a little bit of perhaps advertisements, but make sure to remain tuned in. If you like the stream, make sure to hit the follow button below, or make sure to follow the casters on their respective Twitters, and we'll be back in about 5 to 10 minutes, I hope, with the next match. I don't know for sure, but that's all up to the teams.